Friends, welcome. Welcome to the house of the Lord today. So glad you can join us as we worship God together in this place today. As always, we want to begin with a few announcements. So I call your attention to the screen that's behind me this morning. We call your attention to some announcements today. First of all, remember the Backpack Ministry has started up again, and they feed a couple hundred kids every week for the weekend. So they pack Thursdays at 4:30, they deliver Fridays at 10, especially on Fridays right now is when they could use help. Is that still correct, Stephanie? I'm sorry. So please note that this week it is Wednesday and Thursday for the schools. There must be a different schedule for the schools this week. So please, there's no school this Friday for Howland Schools. Please note it's Wednesday and Thursday for this week. Next, please. So Trunk or Treat is coming up, and what you can do is decorate a car and come in and pass out candy. If you don't want to go that far as taking time to bring in your car in and passing out candy, you can always just donate candy or help with the dinner that night. But it's a great outreach to our community to help put our church on the map and have people come here with kids and find us here and welcome them. So if you want to help with Trunk or Treat, please note that that's on October 29th here at our church. Chat is our Sunday night program. We began last week. There's a studies for all ages at 5 o'clock, and including the adult studies, one that I am leading. I'm trying to do if you were to go to seminary and take a class on beginning to understand the Bible, what that would look like. So if you'd like to participate in that, that's at 5 o'clock, and then there's a free meal at 6 o'clock with all ages together afterwards, just the time of fellowship. Tonight, Matt Channing is making breakfast for dinner. There's gonna be a pancake bar with all the toppings. Again, not this Matt, but a Matt that can cook is cooking that. So please come out Sunday night tonight if you can. Fusion is the children's choir, the community choir that Janelle leads, and so with Sean Reynolds as well, and that's going on. We'd like to have kids participate in that, and it's on Tuesday nights here at the church. It's grades 2 through 8, if any young people would like to be part of that. Preschool needs ears of corn off corn stalks if people are using them for decorating, needed for preschool sensory bins. And so, you don't see this one every day, okay? But if by any chance you're using something like that for decorating, they could use them here for the preschool to help with the church preschool. And a reminder that if your kids like to be in the Christmas musicals, pre-K through second grade, it rehearses during the Sunday school time after the children's sermon, third through sixth grade, right before Chad on Sunday nights at 4 o'clock. We do two separate musicals to make sure all the kids can be part of that, have an age-appropriate one. Are there any other announcements this morning I need to highlight? Looking at Kayla, looking at Janelle. All right, friends, if not, we're going to begin our time of worshiping God together in just a moment. But first, would you please stand and give someone a handshake or a hug and welcome them to the house of the Lord today. Maybe find somebody you don't know today and give them a handshake. Good morning, G. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Jeff. Good morning, brother. Friends, I invite you to remain standing as you return to your places, please. Again, please remain standing if you're able to return to your places. This morning, I'm talking about how we're all aliens in this world, that this world is not really our home, that we have an eternal home, and one day we will fly away to that home. So our opening song today helps us to think about that one day, then we'll fly away. It's this old, beloved hymn. Let's join together in singing, I'll Fly Away.
Life is over, I'll fly away. To and from, I'm God's blessed star, I'll fly away.
I fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, bye bye.
Friends, would you pray with me, please? Lord God, we know that one day we will fly away to our eternal home. We know that this world is just but our temporary home. We're here for just a short while. Why we are here, Lord, let us be filled with your spirit, filled with your love, filled to overflowing. So when we leave this place and go out in the world, your spirit and love would overflow from us into this world that needs it so much. Let your light shine in us, Lord, as long as we are here every day until the day comes when we fly away to our eternal home. In the name of Christ Jesus, we pray. Amen. Friends, you may be seated.
Sometimes the Lord is
All right, friends, before I invite all the kids up for the children's time this morning, my understanding is that we're going to start by showing you a few clips of a little bit what happens in Sunday school, because, you know, you hear every Sunday, you see the children's sermon, you think, oh, that's great, all those kids for the children's sermon. I wonder what they do when they go back there to Sunday school, because obviously the sermon is over their head. You know, although it's children's level, look who's writing it. You would think that maybe it's not so much over their head sometimes, but we want to make sure the kids are getting stuff at their level. So we're going to show you some clips of what they were working on. They were learning about miracles, and then they sing songs and things they learned to reinforce the stories that they learn about back in Sunday school. So we're going to show you a few clips from what happens in Sunday school this morning.
Okay. Who's going to be Jesus?
I want to be Jesus.
Me.
I want to be Jesus.
She's going to be Jesus.
I want to be Jesus.
I want to be Jesus.
Everyone wants to be Jesus. That's great.
Yeah. Jesus had spent a long day preaching to the crowd, and he was very tired. Oh, yes, stand up for a minute. We're not in the boat yet.
Not you.
Yes, hurt you. We're not in the boat yet. Get up. We're over here. Okay? Jesus had been preaching, and he was really, really tired. But he was leaving, and two disciples came up, and they wanted to talk to him. Okay? So, Jesus starts walking.
Jesus,
start walking. All right. Now two people come up to him.
One.
All right. All right.
Too many people up here.
And Jesus said, hey, you can follow me.
Hey, you can follow me.
Okay, hold on. Jesus is going to say that. Go ahead, Jesus. Nice and loud so we can hear you. One more time. Shout it out. All right. Then Jesus said, let's go on the boat and go across the Sea of Galilee. So everybody got on the boat. Good job. Now, the water was calm. Everybody sit down. It was calm. It was a beautiful day. And the disciples began fishing. Disciples, can you put your fishing rod out and fish? Everyone is so happy, but Jesus says, I'm tired. Jesus, can you say I'm tired?
I'm tired.
And so he falls asleep on the boat. Suddenly, the wind begins to blow. Make the wind blow, Emmy. Very good. And the thunder starts to crash. And the lightning starts to flash. Oh my goodness. And the disciples are so afraid. They call out to Jesus. Disciples call for Jesus' help.
Jesus, help!
Jesus wakes up, refreshed. He's not worried about the storm. He says, disciples, why are you afraid?
Because there's a storm outside.
So Jesus does something amazing. He puts his hands out and he says, thunder, stop. He says, lightning, stop. He says, wind, stop. And all of it stops. And the disciples were so amazed. Everybody go, oh. This is when the disciples learned that Jesus is a very special teacher and they can have faith in Jesus. Everybody stand up. Look at the camera and take a bow. Take a bow.
Not yet. All right, Jesus. Are you going to talk to everybody at this all day and night on the beach and then ask them to come help you on the boat?
Yes.
All right. Ask everybody to come help you on the boat.
Come help me on the boat.
All right.
We're going to cross the Sea of Galilee.
We're going to cross the Sea of Galilee.
Oh, stop.
All right.
Me.
Are you guys going to be on the boat with her?
Say stop yes,
Jesus. Say yes, Jesus. We'll
yes,
be on the boat.
Jesus.
We have stop a week. Kicking.
We have a week.
All right. Now listen. So everybody get on the boat.
No more kicking me.
All right, don't kick, please.
Go to sleep.
All right, go to sleep. All right, everybody's on the boat. Everybody's happy. Everybody's fishing. Everybody fish off the boat.
Stop kicking me.
Okay, please stop kicking. All right, so, Jesus, are you asleep on the boat? Everybody else happy and fishing? Okay. Everybody's nice outside. Everybody's gotten fish. All right. Oh, no. What's happening?
The storm's coming.
The storm is coming. Yes. Oh, the wind is up and the thunder and the lightning. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. All right, now, somebody, will you wake up Jesus?
Wake up.
Wake up, Jesus.
Wake up.
Wake up. Jesus, stand up. What are you going to tell the storm? Be still.
Be still.
All right, be still. Oh, my goodness. Now it's smooth sailing again. There's no more thunder. There's no more lightning. There's no more wind. Oh, my goodness. Praise Jesus.
I want to be Jesus this time.
Janelle's saying there's still one more. Okay, 1 second.
Come, follow me.
Wait, I have to walk my pet turtle.
Wait, I have to walk my fish.
Wait, I forgot to take my cat with the flashlight out of the oven.
No, nothing is more important than following me. Get in the boat.
Oh. Jesus is sleeping.
What a nice day.
Yes, the water is calm, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a nice smoky weather, man.
Yeah.
A storm is coming.
We're all gonna drown.
I'm scared.
Let's wake up Jesus.
Yes.
Wake up Jesus. Wake up.
Wake up.
Wake up. Wake up. Father obey him.
Yeah, who is this man?
It's Jesus.
It's Jesus.
It's Jesus.
Let the wing.
Okay, so you can see the story that they were working on last month, and they do it for different age levels, and then they take some of them, get their own script that can read it, or sometimes they read the story and they're just acting out. But the idea is that once they've gone through all 5 years here at our church, they'll have learned all the foundational stories of the Bible. The kids will know all the foundational stories of the Bible and how to apply it to their lives as boys and girls and as they grow up too. So you get a sense of behind the scenes look a little bit about what they're doing. And the kids are going to come up and sing one of the songs that they learned that goes along with this story too. So anyone that's singing first, anyone that's going to be singing the story, Who's That Walking on the Water is the song. If you know that song, I'm going to help you come up and sing Who's That Walking on the Water.
Over me if I'm down. Why is it okay? It's the Wi-Fi.
All right, friends, we just want to get an idea. What do they do back there when we dismiss those kids back there for Sunday school? What kind of things do they work on and stuff? And what are they doing back there? What are our kids learning? And so we just want you to get a sense of that. We want all the other kids to come up and join for the children's time, please. Anybody didn't come up yet, come up and join for the children's time, please. Okay, you got to say good morning more enthusiastically. The adults ready? Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the house of the Lord today, everybody. I'm going to show you, I've got here with me is some stamps. I had a roll of stamps at home, but I have three puppies at my house. And I came home one day to find that they got a roll of stamps somehow. And this is what's left of my roll of stamps. And I came home to find our dog named Butter had stamps stuck to his face. And so I know who the main culprit was. The evidence was on him, okay? And so you see how I've got some like chewed up stamps here? This is what is left of my roll of stamps. I'm patriotic, so I use American flags. We see how like it's half chewed there and stuff. And it was a nice roll. I may be able to use some of these stamps again. I don't know, but I put them in a plastic bag because in a plastic bag, they'll be safe, okay? Maybe the puppies will chew through the bag, but I won't let them get these stamps again, okay? But I'm going to put them back here in this plastic bag, and then the idea is that they'll be safe, they'll be protected in here. Now, I could just throw these away, I suppose, except that I might be able to save some of them, and they're not ruined. I'll be able to, you know, use them. Maybe I'll have to use tape or something, I don't know. But I'll figure out how to use at least some of these stamps, because I could just keep them in the bag like this, but that's not what they were created for. They were created to go on letters, right, and to go into the mail. That's what their purpose is. I also brought a couple plastic forks with me today. You see that these plastic forks are still wrapped in plastic because they're new. Now, I would never have to take these forks out of the plastic. I could just let them in here, and they'd always be clean, right? And they'd never get dirty or anything. But is that what these forks were created for, to stay in the plastic and never be used? What were they created for?
To use.
To use, right? And I'm going to eat one day with these forks, right? So they have a purpose. They were created for a purpose. So I could just leave them in the plastic, but that wouldn't be what they were created for. So my kids, as you know, my kids are big now. They're grown up now. I still have one in high school, but my older kids are all in college or older. And when they grew up, I didn't leave them wrapped in plastic. And what I mean by that is I didn't try to shelter them really from the world. I let them know that there's a world out there, and I let them have friends who aren't Christians, and they're involved in all kinds of activities and stuff like that, and I wanted them to experience the whole world and not just be wrapped in plastic. Sometimes we think that we have to keep ourselves completely separate from the whole world, because I said earlier that my message today is that we're like aliens, okay? Not that I'm from outer space, although if you know me, maybe you think that sometimes, right? But it means that my real home is heaven. My forever home is heaven. That's where I'll be one day. So while I'm here on this world, I could just keep myself wrapped up from the rest of the world and never really be friends with anybody that's not a Christian, or just keep to myself all the time and not try to spread God's love. But that's not what I was created for. I was created to have God's love inside me, but to share it with the world, not just to keep myself wrapped up and protected, but to know that maybe sometimes all my feelings will get hurt, and maybe sometimes someone will hurt me if I'm trying to share love, and everyone doesn't live that way. But I was created, kind of like this fork was created to use to eat with, I was created to have God's love in me and share it with the world. And so that's what I want to do. I wanted to try to have my kids do that, and all of you do that, and everyone learn that God created us for a purpose, okay? And that's to share God's love. So this world is not our forever home. Heaven is. But we're here for a long time. You're going to be here for a long time. And while you're here, you want to know that God's love is always inside of you, and that we were created to share that love with others. Okay, let's say a little prayer together, everybody. Dear God, thank you so much that heaven is our forever home, and that maybe we've got grandmas or grandpas or aunts or uncles or people that we know and love who are in that forever home with you. But we're going to be here for a long time. And while we're here, Lord, help us to live every day knowing we were created for a purpose. You created us not just to be keeping to ourselves, but to try to share your love with everybody we can. So help us to be boys and girls who try to share your love with everyone that we can the way you created us to. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, thanks, everybody. You can go back to Children's Church. So friends, the kids are heading out to Children's Church now, and you just got a sense of the kind of stuff that they do when they're out there in Children's Church, what they're going out to do this morning. And if you ever want to be part of helping with that on Sunday mornings, they ask people to help just a couple months a year. So if you want to do 2 months a year or something like that and help out with the children's ministry, they'd love to have you involved with that. You can see the kind of things the kids do. And as they head out this morning, we always take time to share joys and concerns with one another. So if you have a joy or a concern this morning to share, please raise your hand and an usher will bring a microphone to you.
Still undiagnosed as it is now, but we will find the answer to it, and God is good all the time. All the time, God is good.
Amen. So Sandy was just in the hospital recently as well, so please continue to keep Sandy in your prayers.
Gianna had a life-threatening reaction to a medication. She's been in the hospital at Children's Maine since Wednesday night.
So please keep Gianna in your prayers as well. I assume you know that lady you're taking the microphone to there, Jim.
Why, thank you, sir. This prayer is for our dog, Izzy. She has a mass growing on her, and she has been prescribed medication, and she's a very, very anxious dog. You can ask Mike. But we are praying that the medicine alone will be enough to fix whatever the mass is. Thank you.
And speaking of dogs, the Headlands lost their family dog, Juno, so please keep the Headlands in your prayers. As you know, they're part of the family, so please keep the Headlands in your prayers as well.
Early in July, we donated a service for eight flatware to the church for the garage sale. So if somebody bought that set, I have a joy for them because I have a fork to use. And It's here, so Bonnie will have it afterwards. I got to go count. But anyway, so if anybody knows who bought that or you bought it yourself, here's a fork to use.
So if you didn't know, Bob and Bonnie moved recently. The good news was that Bob did eventually find his underwear, if you didn't hear about that. So, but now he's found a fork as well. If you bought that at the garage sale, there's another fork for you.
Hi, my name is Carrie Behringer, and I would ask for prayers for my son Lucas. He had a concussion last Tuesday at a soccer game. He got headbutted in the back of the head and then fell on his forehead. But this is his second one in 6 months, and the first one was really, really bad. He was out of school for weeks. So prayers that he can get back to playing soccer like he loves.
So please keep Lucas in your prayers. I should keep the family of Karen Jaggers in your prayers, a prayer request that was texted into me this morning. So please keep the family of Karen Jaggers in your prayers as she passed away as well. Are there others this morning, joys or concerns to share? All right, friends, if not, we're going to prepare our hearts for prayer this morning. And Elizabeth's going to come up here and join Ken, and she's going to help us sing. Our hymns are requested this morning. We haven't done this one, I think, in a while. It's God Will Take Care of You. Friends, would you please join with me for a moment of silent prayer as we come to our God together in prayer today. Lord God, as we gather together in this place this morning, we give you our thanks, we give you our praise, for you are an awesome God. worthy of our praise, and we gather here to worship you, Lord, to lift you up, to humble ourselves, to know that we are the creation and you are the creator of all. And each of us, you give us the gift of life itself, making us in your image, Lord, to be a reflection of you and your love here on this earth. That's why we were created, to be a reflection of your love. So, Lord, may we not just shelter ourselves from the world and ignore that there's a world out there with lots of problems, with hungry people in it, Lord, and people who don't know you and your love, but may we live our lives the way that you created us to. People who are filled with your spirit and filled with your love, and letting that overflow from us, letting your light shine through us, Lord, guiding the way and pointing the way to you, so that all might know that this world is just a temporary place for each one of us, that there's an eternal home where we'll be one day. But while we're here, Lord, in this world, may we remember the words that we've just sung together, that God will take care of us, of every need that we have, Lord, that we can surrender it all, lay it all at your feet, no matter what we're facing or our loved ones facing, Lord, knowing that God who created the universe is bigger than any problem that we face, bigger even than death itself, for you sent your son Jesus to conquer death and give us eternal life. So, Lord, we know that no matter what we wrestle with, no matter what our loved ones do, that we have nothing to fear, for God will take care of us in ways that go beyond our understanding. But in faith, Lord, we lift up to you people that we've mentioned today. We pray for Sandy, Lord. You continue to heal her and help the doctors diagnosing what's going on with her. We pray for Gianna, Lord, as she's facing this difficulty with her medication. We pray that will be regulated, Lord, and she'll be home and healthy soon. We pray for the family of Karen Jaggers, Lord, that you'd give them comfort and strength with this time. Pray for Lucas as he recovers from this concussion. I've had a couple of them now, Lord, and we just pray that against any future concussions, and we just pray that you'll touch him and heal him. We pray for the Headlands in their time of mourning for their dog, and for Izzy, Lord, another dog facing a hard time. Lord, we pray not only for each other as individuals, as brothers and sisters, but even for pets or animals, Lord, or people that are close to us, because we're a family. And we know, Lord, that we are called to love each other and to care for each other. And what matters to each of us, Lord, matters to you as well. And so we lift all these things up to you, Lord, all these people, all these needs, Lord, knowing that you are God, and again, trusting that you will take care of us. It's not just something that we sing, not just something we read about in the Bible, but something that we know in our hearts that we claim through faith, Lord. And so we know that you will take care of every situation. But not, Lord, just for these individual things, but for bigger things going on in the world. We can see on the news what's going on in the Middle East, Lord, for strife that seems to never end. And sometimes it's about religion, and religion being something that divides people instead of bringing them together in love. Or it's continuing to happen in Ukraine or around the world, Lord, that we still live in a world where people hurt each other, where they fight over borders and domination and power struggles and things, Lord, that you long for us to set aside and learn to live in peace, in unity, in love. And so let the people of God, Lord, be the people who lead the way in that. Take us, Lord, and fill us again with your spirit and love. Let it shine through us. Let us go out in the world and spread your love everywhere we possibly can. Let Christians, Lord, be the ones who try to light the way, letting people see that you long for us to live in peace and love and unity. And we pray all these things together this morning in the name of your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the one who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus said that where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. We worship God at this time through the offering of our hearts and our treasures. Would you pray with me, please? Lord God, we give you thanks and praise for all the blessings you give to each one of us. In gratitude, Lord, for all that we've been blessed with, we present this offering to you. We pray you'll take it, Lord, and somehow use it to spread your love and your will in this world, Lord. We just pray that someone who doesn't know your love, who doesn't know that you are real, will somehow be touched by what we give and know that you and your love are real. In the name of Christ Jesus, we pray. Amen. Friends, you may be seated. And before we start our next hymn, just so you know, like I tell the music people, this is my theme. This Sunday I'm talking about being an alien and how I'm not really from this world kind of thing. This is a temporary home. And you may not have noticed, but all the songs that Ken put together, he arranges that stuff, he hears it in his head. It's all things like Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, Coming Forward to Carry Me Home, and songs like that, that he was putting together, that he has that God-given ability to like match the theme and just like put it together. It's amazing, the musical talent and the talent we have, the blessings that we have in this church of the wonderful people. So I just wanted to point that out to you. I'm always amazed, like, my gosh, he doesn't have any music. He doesn't have any music, he just does that. It's amazing. But we're going to join together in singing another requested hymn this morning because it's one that reminds us, I'm talking later about how we need to stay close to the cross, attached to the cross. And so this hymn is The Old Rugged Cross. So that last verse, especially for us to think about today, that he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. It's a forever home. Heaven is. This world is not our home. Heaven is our eternal home. And we're going to look at a few scriptures that remind us that we're in this world, but not really of this world. They're both found in the Gospel of John, reading first from John 15 and then from John 17. Hear these words from John 15, 18 and 19. If the world hates you, keep in mind that it hated me first. If you belonged to the world, it would love you as its own. As it is, you do not belong to the world, but I have chosen you out of the world. That is why the world hates you. And hear these words also from John 17. I've given them your word, and the world has hated them, for they are not of the world any more than I am of the world. My prayer is not that you take them out of the world, but that you protect them from the evil one. They are not of the world, even as I am not of it. Sanctify them by the truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, I have sent them into the world. The idea of this passage, of course, Jesus is not really of this world. He's been sent into this world. He's sending others out into the world in his name, asking that God protect them from this world, but he's still sending them out into the world. Friends, would you please take a moment to pray with me and for me? O Lord, may the words of my mouth and meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Well, I've been doing this whole sermon series on all the different things that I am, you know, all these different strange things that I am, if you've been following along each week. And today I tell you that I am an alien. And admit it. Those of you who've known me for a while, you've always suspected it, right? You've always suspected, yeah, he's probably an alien. But what I mean, of course, as I've been saying, is that this world is not my home, and an alien is someone who's not of this world. I'm not of this world. I don't know how long I'll be in this world, 90 years, 100 years, who knows? But however long I'm here in this world, it's just a blip compared to all of eternity, the time that I'll spend in my eternal home. I'm an alien in this world, and so are all of you. We all come from another world, and because of that, I've always thought that aliens would be a good name, like for a youth group or something like that, right? To remind them that they're in the world but not of the world. Maybe the junior high here could start calling themselves the aliens. I'll have to talk to the youth leaders about that or something, because some of them actually look like aliens. Have you noticed that? You know, the way they dress and do things sometimes these days, and certainly teenagers act like it sometimes, right? I know my kids did at that age. What would alien stand for? How about amazing love in every normal student? Something like that, you know? When we think of aliens, we usually think of aliens from movies or television. I'm going to show you a few clips today to help you think about how we usually think of aliens. It's big money. There's big money in blockbuster movies, right? Like Independence Day with Will Smith. That's your cue. Like Independence Day with Will Smith. Coming to conquer the world.
Operation Spy Job.
Boys from air traffic red say the skies are clear.
It's the real thing. Radio signal from another world.
Mr. President,
our intelligence tells us the object is settled into a stationary orbit.
Part of it is broken off into nearly three dozen other pieces.
Smaller than the whole, sir.
Yet over 15 miles in width themselves.
Where are they heading?
They should be entering our atmosphere within the next 25 minutes.
Earthquake!
Let's just get there as quickly as
What's
possible.
What's the rush, huh? People get to Washington and won't be there.
It is confirmed. The unexplained phenomenon is headed for Moscow.
It's like a chess. First, they're positioning the pieces using this one signal to synchronize their efforts.
And then what?
Checkmate.
God.
I really don't think they flew 90 billion light years to start a fight.
They're gonna stop them! They're gonna kill us all!
God, I hope they bring back Elvis!
There's gonna be a lot of frightened people out there.
Yeah. I'm one of them.
Of movies like this. They're big blockbuster things. There's a huge industry. There's all these things of aliens, and they're coming to conquer the world, War of the Worlds and things like that. It's how we usually think of aliens. When I say alien, that's the kind of thing that comes to your mind, some creature from another planet. And it's not just movies. There used to be an old television show called The Twilight Zone, and I used to love, because I'm a nerd, so I love that old stuff too. And in The Twilight Zone, one of my favorite episodes is one where they have a book called To Serve Man. And the idea is that these aliens have come to serve us, and they're doing all these things on Earth to make Earth better. But then they learn at the end that there's a twist, and to serve man, the title of the book means something very different. Can you play that clip for us, please, Brandon?
Number 914 from Earth to our planet. We will be taking off in 3 minutes.
Mr. Chambers! Mr. Chambers, don't get on that ship. The rest of the book, To Serve Man, it's a cookbook.
No! 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 Ah! No! No!
So there's this twist at the end, and To Serve Man is actually a cookbook, how the different ways that you can serve human beings kind of thing. There's all this alien stuff like this, and there's so much of that out there in books and movies and television shows and stuff. But I want to end this morning by showing you about my favorite alien, and that's E.T. So we're going to show you a clip about E.T., and I'm going to tell you in the end why I'm trying to be a lot more like E.T., and all these other aliens that you see and hear and read about and see in movies. So here's a clip from E.T.
Stay. Ouch. Ouch.
if you've seen it, you remember the movie E.T.? E.T. is just trying to get home, right? He's not trying to conquer the world. He's not trying to eat anybody. He's just trying to get home to his real home. And while he was here on earth, he was just trying to let his light shine and touch some other people. And he says at the end, I'll be right here. I'm going to stay with you. I'll be in your memory. I'll be in your heart. You'll remember me. I'll stay here with you. But E.T. is just trying to get home to his real home. And that reminds me, that's what I'm here for. One day I'll be in my eternal home. One day I'll fly away as we sung together. One day I'll be in my eternal home. But here, now, while I'm here, I'm just trying to let my light shine. I'm just trying to let God's light shine through me. I'm trying to live with different values than the rest of the world does. You heard me say to the kids earlier, you know, I could have taken my own kids and tried to wrap them up and isolate them and say, you can't play with any kid that's not a Christian as you're growing up. You can't, I'm going to isolate you from the world. I'm going to put you in a bubble, basically, and say, you can't be part of this world because this world's messed up and I don't want it messing you up. I'm going to keep you safe from the world. And Jesus prays in that scripture, we said, just keep them safe, Lord, but I'm sending them out into the world. So, you know, we didn't homeschool our kids. It's fine if people do that. It wasn't for us because we want our kids to be in the world, trying to shape the world, trying to transform the world, trying to take God's light that's inside of them and letting it shine for others to see and try to draw them to God's love. The trick is to live in this world, but not to live the way the rest of the world does. This temporary world that we live in teaches us different values than our eternal home does. This world teaches us to be obsessed with money and material possessions. It teaches us to live for ourselves, to look out for number one. And every day on television, we're bombarded with commercials telling us about all these products that we need and things that we need to make our lives better somehow. And these values are not at all what the Word of God teaches us. These values are not the same as the eternal values God teaches us. But I can't have my kids or any of us live in a bubble. We were created, this fork was created to be used to eat with. I can't just keep it in plastic. I can't keep myself isolated from the world. Jesus sent his disciples, it says in our passage today of scripture, into the world, just asking God to keep them safe as they went into the world and tried to change the world and transform it with the different values that they had inside of them, including soon at Pentecost, God's Spirit that we have still today within us to fill us and guide us. But how do we do that? How do we stay connected to God? How do we stay connected to God when we have all these values surrounding us all the time, all these voices in our ear telling us to live differently than God tells us to? I believe we have to stay lashed to the mast. What do I mean by that? One of my favorite parts of the great epic Greek poem, The Odyssey, is the scene where Odysseus is going past the island of the Sirens. The island is inhabited by beautiful women, if you remember this, named Sirens, who sing out to sailors on the sea to draw them in to their destruction. Odysseus says the men of his ship stuff their ears so they cannot hear the sounds of the Sirens singing. In other words, he places them in a kind of bubble so they can't hear what's going on in the world around them. He isolates them from the Sirens. But Odysseus himself lashes himself to his ship's mast so he can hear the songs but not be able to respond to their call. And in this way, his ship makes it safely past the island and he makes it safely home. What does it mean for us today to be lashed to the mast? Our best strategy for defeating Satan, for defeating the seductive call and values of this world upon our lives or our kids' or grandkids' lives, isn't to live wrapped up in a bubble, isolated from the world. It's to stay lashed to the mast, even when we hear the sounds of this world calling us. But our mast, the mast of our ship, is the cross. We need to stay intentionally close to the cross, tied to the cross, tied to the church, to the Word of God, and to other Christians. We hear the sounds of this world. We feel the temptations of this world, but we are called to stay lashed to the mast, close to the cross, close to the Word of God, and let God's Spirit be within us leading us and guiding us. Now, of course, there are times for all of us when we don't stay lashed to the mast, when we hear the sounds tempting us in this world, when we fall into sin, and we all make bad choices. We've all done it. We'll continue to do it. But when we do that, we have to remember how it happens. What do I mean by that? Two young men join a construction company, building a multi-story building. At lunch, they sat themselves on an iron girder high above the ground and opened their lunch boxes. "I can't believe it," groaned Joe. "Peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. I don't like peanut butter and jelly." With that, he crumpled his sandwiches and hurled them to the ground. Lunch on the second day was a repeat of the first. Joe became visibly upset with his sandwiches and his lunch. Once again, he hurled the sandwiches 17 stories below. Joe's buddy dreaded lunch on the following day. Sure enough, he was stuck once more, listening to his coworker complain. Day after day, he silently watched Joe sort through his lunch, get upset over his peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, and send them hurtling to the ground. Finally, one day, Joe's buddy blurted out, "Look, if you don't like peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, tell your wife to stop making them for you." Joe looked at his friend and snapped, "Hey, buddy, don't bring my wife into this. I make my own sandwiches." It's a joke, okay, but there's part of that that is very true about life. One of the hardest things involved in getting talking to people to come in my office that are trying to work things out in their lives, or counselors who really do this for a living, one of the hardest things to get people to realize is that they make their own sandwiches. They make their own sandwiches. They make their own choices. When they make mistakes, when they lie or cheat or steal or smoke or use drugs or hurt people they love somehow with their words or actions, they're making these choices themselves. We all tend to blame the world somehow. We know the world is messed up with all its values and all the pressures it puts on us in so many ways. We know that. But we are responsible for our own choices. We are responsible for our own actions, for making our own sandwiches, if you will. And I don't mean when bad things happen to us. I don't mean when someone has an illness or a loved one dies or has an accident. I mean that we all make the wrong choices in life sometimes. Even pastors, we all do. We all make mistakes, even though we know we have God's Spirit in us to lead us and guide us. But we don't always listen to that voice inside us. Sometimes we hear the voices of the world, the temptations of this world, the values of this world leading us astray. So we have to stay lashed to the mast. We have to stay close to the heart of God. We have to hear God's Spirit, God's voice within us leading us and guiding us. We can't forget that we are aliens. We're in this world just a little while. We have an eternal home with eternal values that are different in the way the rest of this world lives. We have to remember, sometimes we make our own sandwiches. We make our own mistakes. We're responsible for our decisions. How do we make better decisions? How do we live the way God wants us to, and not the way the world does, which causes us to make bad decisions and for our lives to go off course sometimes? We stay lashed to the mast, to the cross. We stay close to God. We hear God's voice. We listen for God's voice every day. And when we face trials or temptations in life, pray. We reach out to God, and we listen to God respond to us. If we do, God's voice will talk to us. We'll be able to hear it, maybe in the voice of a friend, maybe in a word of God from Scripture, maybe in a song. But we'll hear God speaking to us, leading us and guiding us and reminding us we're aliens in this world. We're just here for a little while. And we aren't called to live the way the rest of the world does. But the good news for all of us aliens is that when we make mistakes, as we all do, sometimes when we go off the path and don't live the way God wants us to, there's forgiveness. There's forgiveness. Max Lucado tells this story in his book, No Wonder They Call Him Savior. The small house was simple but adequate. It consisted of one large room on a dusty street. Its red tiled roof was one of many in this poor neighborhood on the outskirts of the Brazilian village. It was a comfortable home. Maria and her daughter, Christina, had done what they could to add color to the gray walls and warmth to the hard dirt floor. An old calendar, a faded photograph of a relative, a wooden crucifix. The furnishings were modest, a pallet on either side of the room, a wash basin, a wood-burning stove. Maria's husband had died when Christina was an infant. The young mother, steadily, stubbornly refusing opportunities to remarry, got a job and set out to raise her young daughter. And now, 15 years later, the worst years were over. Though Maria's salary as a maid offered just a few luxuries, it was reliable and it did provide food and clothes. And now Christina was old enough to get a job to help out. Some said Christina got her independence from her mother. She recoiled at the traditional idea of marrying young and raising a family in that culture. Not that she couldn't have had a husband. Her olive skin and brown eyes kept a steady stream of prospects at her door. She spoke often of going to the city. She dreamed of trading her dusty neighborhood for exciting avenues and city life. Just the thought of this horrified her mother. Maria was always quick to remind Christina of the harshness of the streets. People don't know you there. Jobs are scarce and then life is cruel. And besides, if you went there, what would you do for a living? Maria knew exactly what Christina would have to do. That's why her heart broke when she awoke one morning to find her daughter's bed empty. Maria knew immediately where her daughter had gone. She also knew immediately what she must do to find her. She quickly threw some clothes in a bag, gathered up all the money that she had, and ran out of the house. On her way to the bus stop, she entered a drugstore to get one last thing. Pictures. Pictures of herself. She sat in a photograph booth, closed the curtain, and spent all she could on pictures of herself. With her purse full of small black and white photos, she boarded the next bus to Rio de Janeiro. Maria knew Christina had no way of earning money. She also knew her daughter was too stubborn to give up. When pride meets pain like this, a human will do things that were before unthinkable. Knowing this, Maria began her search. Bars, hotels, nightclubs, any place with a reputation for streetwalkers or prostitutes. She went to the mall, and in each place she left her picture taped to a hotel bulletin board, fastened to a corner phone booth, and on the back of each photo, she wrote a note. It wasn't too long before both the money and the pictures ran out, and Maria had to go home. The weary mother wept as the bus began the long journey back to her small village. It was a few weeks later that young Christina descended the hotel stairs. Her face was tired. Her brown eyes no longer danced with youth, but spoke of pain and fear. Her laughter was broken. Her dream had become a nightmare. 1,000 times over, she had longed to trade these countless beds for her secure pallet back home. Yet the little village was, in many ways, so far away. As she reached the bottom of the stairs, her eyes noticed a familiar face. She looked again, and there on the lobby mirror was a small picture of her mother. Christina's eyes burned and her throat tightened as she walked across the room and removed the small photo. Written on the back of the picture were these simple words: "Whatever you have done, whatever you have become, it doesn't matter. Please come home. I love you." She did. That's the way the story ends. Yeah, we're responsible for our own choices, right? We make our own sandwiches. We're responsible for our own choices, and we all screw up sometimes. But no matter what we've done, no matter the mistakes that we've made, God forgives us and will welcome us home. We have an eternal home. Just like this mom would welcome her daughter home, so God will welcome us home. There's a story like that in the Bible, the story of the prodigal son. You probably know it. There's a son who wants to go out into the world and live out the values of the world, and he parties it up, and he does whatever money he has. He goes through it all. He just wants to be part of this world. And then he runs out of everything, and he realizes this world has given him nothing, and he has nothing, and he longs to return home. And he says, oh, maybe I could just be a servant and eat the way the servants do. But when he goes back home, his father comes and runs down the road and meets him with his arms open wide. And he welcomes him home as a son, as his child, and forgives him. There's story after story like this of God and God's love. Friends, whatever you've done, whatever mistakes you've made in life, whatever mistakes your loved ones have made. Other people have made them too. Everyone has made mistakes, but we're forgiven. God forgives us. And all he says to us is like that mother, whatever you've done, whatever you've become, it doesn't matter. Please come home. I love you. We can come back home to God. He runs down the road to meet us with his arms open wide, and he welcomes us home. And then, one day, he'll welcome us into an eternal home. For this world is not our real home. It's a temporary home. We live in it for a while. But while we do, we're aliens. Not like all those other clips I showed you, right? But like E.T. E.T. is just trying to get home. He knows this world is not his home. He's just trying to get home. And while he's here, he's trying to let his light shine for others to see. And that's how it should be with us, friends. We're aliens in this world. We know one day we'll be going home. We know we'll be forgiven for everything we've done. We'll be going to an eternal home. And while we're here, we let our light shine for others to see. But while we're here also, we don't isolate ourselves. We don't wrap ourselves in plastic, in a plastic bubble. That's not what we're created for. We were created like Jesus did with the disciples in our scripture. He said, yeah, you're not of this world, but I'm sending you into this world. I'm sending you out there to change it, to transform it, to tell people about my love, to have my spirit come alive in them, in their hearts, so they can have an eternal home as well. And that's our mission. Not to isolate ourselves, not to live our lives in a bubble, but to know that God is sending us, when we leave this place, out into the world, to let his spirit and love overflow from us, to let his light shine through us, to go out in the world and try to change it for him. We live in a world where, in the Middle East, where they know all about God, they're bombing and hurting each other. In Ukraine and Russia and all around this world, we still live in a world where people hurt each other. And we do it individually in our lives as well. Let the people of God be the people who lead the way. Let the people of God be the people who live by a different set of values, one where God is alive in our hearts, leading us and guiding us. And let us not keep ourselves isolated, wrapped in a bubble, but go out in the world and share his love and spread his love. Be sent out of the world like disciples, just the way Jesus sent out those disciples into the world. Let us change this world into what God wants to be. And that begins, of course, by changing ourselves into who God wants us to be. So let's stay lashed to the mast, to the cross. Let us hear the sounds of things going on in this world, but not listen to them, but listen to the voice of God. Let that lead us and guide us and our kids and our grandkids. And let God send us into the world to change this world into the place God wants it to be. I'm an alien. So are you. We're just here a little while. Don't be like the world. Change the world. Listen to the voice of God's Spirit inside you. Let it guide you every day. Change yourself and change the world into all God wants it to be. Amen. Friends, From the Ground is going to come forward and lead us in a song we haven't done many times, but its message, its lyrics, is one that's perfect to what we're talking about today. So I invite you to please stand if you're able. If you know it, of course, you're welcome to sing along. But if not, I invite you to listen to these words as Firm the Ground leads us in this song that kind of summarizes again what we're talking about today.
Sometimes it feels like I'm washing.
I'm not home yet. This is not where I belong, not you either. We're not home yet. We have an eternal home. But while we're here in this world for just a little while, this world that needs God's love so much, we were created to go out into this world and be aliens in it, not live with the values of this world, but try to change it. Every time we pray the Lord's Prayer, we pray for God's kingdom to come here on earth as it is in heaven. But we shouldn't just be praying for that. We should be trying to live it out and put it into action. We've been called to do that with our lives, created to do that with our lives. So let us take the eternal values that are in us. Let us take the voice of God, His Spirit within us, and let us let it lead us and guide us and go out in the world and change it. Because this world is not our home. We're not home yet. But while we're here, let us do all we can to make this world all that God longs for it to be and for all people to know. This world is not their home. As you leave this place and do so with your lives, may the blessings of God the Father Almighty, Jesus Christ, His Son, our Lord and Savior, and the peace and unity of the Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you forevermore. Amen.